So I was asked the question, what do I think about Nuttall bred petadils? Well, Brian Nuttall is a legend in the petadil world. And you will be hard-pressed to find a petadil that doesn't have any traces back to Brian. Brian started his breeding practices in 1960, so 61 years ago, and used a blood of Cyril Bray and Frank Buck, who are both earlier petadil breeders. And especially Cyril is known as one of the fathers of the breed, but also Frank Buck has done a great amount. To that he added the blood of his grandfather. So the grandfather of Brian in this case, and the grandfather of Brian always took great pride that he used his small pit dogs in the mix. And those small pit dogs were not your Staffordshire Bull Terriers. They were a separate breed known as the Northumberland Terrier. I made a separate video about this, but to quickly tell you, Northumberland Terriers were dogs a lot smaller than the canine to canine pit dogs, and that were also used underground because of their small size. So these dogs have a lot of the fighting dog characteristics, but also in a completely warrior attitude towards quarry, so to say, for example foxes or badgers. And if you ask me in one sentence what makes the Brian Nuttall dogs that good, and also for the type, is that they also included this Northumberland Terrier, which were small pit dogs, which gave the dogs a lot more courage, fighting ability, and still remain in the small package. Up to this day, you sometimes see that people cross in pit type of dogs, being American Pit Bull Terrier, Staffordshire Bull Terrier, or English Bull Terrier, to increase the power, strength, courage, and also the silent working abilities that are known for the petadil terrier breed. So a pit dog doesn't have benefit to be a dog that would just bark and bay at its prey like many of the white Russells do. So that gave it a great benefit as a silent type of strong dog. And Brian has bred them for so many years that they really put a stamp on the petadil terrier as a breed, and he refined it as a breed we can now love and cherish as what it is. Still the diversity of the breed is high because they are working terriers. But if one breeder has gave them more uniformity, especially to the smoother coat varieties, and also those pit dogs of Northumberland, they did not need extremely big coat, because that would just hamper them to transition the heat, and also put on additional weight, which is less functional than, for example, muscle mass. And I think that if you would breed the original Fell Terrier, or the original Black and Tan Terrier, that already had quite a lot of Northumberland Terriers in the makeup as well, with Northumberland Terriers, or the modern equivalents, so it's very small warrior type of dogs, you would come very close to the petadil as we know it now. The reason why this question was asked about the neutral lines is that they heard conflicting stories about the quality. Some people say that the nuttall bread patadils are of the finest quality. I just gave you some examples why they could be, especially because they are heavy on the Northumberland blood and also obtained through years of selection using a wide pool of patadils to use the best. So that's a benefit, and the contradiction is that others tell you that nuttall patadils are not what they used to be, and this is correct too. And why is that? In the past, these dogs were bred by Brian Nuttall and selected and then refined. Well, currently, oftentimes, just other black dogs are acquired and then sold under the Nuttall prefix. So now some of the Nuttall dogs that are sold are real Nuttall dogs, so to say. So bred and selected and defined by Brian Nuttall or his family. And there are rumors that others are just bought and then sold in the fame of Brian Nuttall for a pretty penny. So for example, they tell that they are bought for X and then sold for 3x X just because they have the Nuttall name attached. And if that is true, of course it will give you insight why the quality is not what it used to be. Also, of course, because people age would not be more reasonable that Brian is not digging himself anymore. And also his family, for example his sons, has reached an age that it would be harder to work themselves, etc. So sometimes the legacy can also be hampered by a more trivial thing such as age. And it gives you an additional insight. So long story short, Brian Nuttall is a legend. He has really put a stamp on the Patadil Terrier breed. Also, in my opinion, a very good one. Adding that Northumberland Terrier blood, which is a small pit dog, has resulted in the athletic and characters that we now know and love about the Patadil. Also, he has brought a lot of uniformity, especially the smooth-coated Patadil Terriers. On the other hand, the rumors that the quality might be different in time tend to be true due to a different type of circumstances. And I just should be happy that one guy has made so much difference to the breed and also improved the breed to my understanding. To a great extent. Have a great day. And please respect also those that did work in the past and now are not able to do the same, of course.